The next topic of the chapter is to find the square roots. So square root is just opposite of square and it is represented by the symbol under root of x or square root of x, where x can be any natural number. There are three methods by which we can find the square root. First method is by prime factorization method. Second is by method of repeated subtraction. And the third one is by long division method. So here we will solve the questions by all the three methods. So first we will learn to find the square root of any number by prime factorization method. We have one question: find the square root of 1296 by prime factorization method. So it is very clear that for solving this question by prime factorization method, we have to find its prime factors. So these are the prime factors of 1296. So 1296 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Step number 2 is to make the pairs. One pair of 2 is completed, followed by another pair of 2, then pair of 3 and another pair of 3. So 2 into 2 is written as 2 square multiplied by 2 square multiplied by 3 square multiplied by 3 square. By using laws of exponent, we have 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 whole square, which is equal to 2 into 2 4, 4 into 3 12, into 3 36, that is 36 whole square. As I told you that square root is just opposite of square, so we will shift this square from RHS to LHS. On shifting the power, square becomes square root. So square root of 1296, 36. So this is the method by which we can find the square root of any number, and the method is prime factorization method. So our second method is method of repeated subtraction, by which we can find the square root of any perfect square. In this method, we have to continuously subtract the consecutive odd natural numbers until we get 0. For that, we have taken one question and we have find the square root of 121 by method of repeated subtraction. So 121 is subtracted by the first odd natural number, that is 1, which gives 120. Then we have to continue the subtraction until we get 0. Now 120 is subtracted from the second consecutive odd natural number, that is 3. Then we get 117. Then 117 is subtracted from 5, that gives 112. So similarly, we have done the subtraction to get 0. After that, once you get 0, you have to count the total number of steps: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. So the square root of 121 is 11. We will do one more question. Like, we will find the square root of 36 by this method. So first we will subtract 1, that gives 35. Then 35, we will subtract 3, that gives 32, followed by 5, that gives 27. After 27, we will subtract 7 from 27, that gives 20. Then 20 minus 9, that gives 11. 11 minus, after 9 we get 11, that gives 0. So count the number of steps: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So the square root of 36 is 6.